I'm here at the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy in Oxnard, shooting another episode of the Robert Garcia Reality Show. Check it out. Did people talk about you at all, Robert? Did anybody hate on you? Because everybody liked you when you were fighting. You didn't have a lot of haters.
I never talked bad about anybody. But see, Robert, when I was fighting, there was no Facebook, no Twitter, no YouTube. So exactly, none of that. So that you didn't hear it that much. You didn't read it that often.
And when they meet you, they all love you. Hey, you know,
exactly. It's like Brandon. So you get a lot of people talking bad about him, but they meet him and they fucking want a picture.
So autograph.
Exactly. It's just the way it is. You know, we gotta know that's just life, and we're gonna have a lot of haters, but that gets us stronger, especially here in Oxnard.
You know what's crazy? This is the quietest this gym has ever been since the first day I walked in here. Why is that? Earlier in the day? It's too early?
I think the Brandon's not here, that's why.
Hey, Pelos, why is it so quiet at the gym right now? It's too early in the day?
Brandon's not here. Brandon's not here, so it's a little quiet.
Hey, Robert, why is it so quiet in the gym?
Brandon's not here.
That's what everybody tells me.
Brandon's not here, right?
There's no replacement? Cecilio, you're not going to be loud?
No, that's Brandon's job.
Brandon's right now in Kansas with his wife. In the past years, whenever he went to Kansas and he would call you, what did you expect from that phone call?
He's in jail. He needs money to bail him out. He broke somebody's jaw. You know, he's on the run there. You know, Robert, I'm in my mom's house. The house is surrounded by cops. They're going to arrest me, just so you can know. Tell Cameron to cancel my fight.
And now, if he calls, you're not worried about that?
No, I'm not worried, because, you know, he's smart now. He's a world champion, and he knows that there's so much out there that he's going to lose, and he's got Vicky with him, so that means...
That will calm him down.
Oh, yeah.
What are you asking, Julian? What do you want?
Circus.
You want to go to the circus? Why? You like clowns and elephants?
Yeah.
They sometimes say this gym is a circus.
Yeah.
Who's the funniest dude in the gym right now?
Right now?
Because Brandon's not here.
Try B. Donald.
Donald, why?
He just says stupid stuff sometimes.
Like what?
Just telling his stories.
Give me an example.
Or, no. Well, his son's not here. His son's the funniest kid in the gym.
Andrew?
Yeah.
Well, why do you guys say that?
Moron.
He's
a moron.
He won't be offended if he sees this on the internet?
No. He'll be happy.
Hey, Robert, who threw the papers on you in the trip? When you guys were driving to the tournament, who was throwing stuff at you? You were sitting in the front of the van? And who was
It was a fucking...
I don't want the kids to trip.
Watch. We're fucking driving. And the kids are throwing stuff to each other. So then,
like what? Like pretzels, candy, or
no gum, spitball, paper, spit.
Spitball.
In your van.
Yeah. So I feel one in my head. And I hit the brakes. And I said,
"Who the fuck did that?"
Before I finished, Robert, it was me. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. It was me.
The biggest kid of all of them.
Robert, it was me. I'm sorry. It was me. It wasn't meant to hit you. Fucking pussy.
It was crazy.
You fucking pussy, you're not my dad anymore.
You got disowned by your son?
Yeah. Margarito beat Cotto fair and square. You know, he's just stronger, hungrier, and he came in great shape and beat him, and that's what he's gonna do again.
Margarito cracks a lot of jokes, he has a good sense of humor. Cotto doesn't smile ever. Which kind of fighter do you like to work with?
Ah, well, of course, with a Margarito type of fighter, with a Brandon Rios type of fighter, and everybody in my gym. Hey, I go up north to train Nonito. That's all we get, you know, jokes. We play around. Nonito's inside sparring happy. We get out of the ring, he's happy. We play around. You know, we go eat together. We do stuff together.
So
you know, that's my team. That's the way I like to.
Why do you think Cotto's so angry? What is it? If you had to analyze, like.
You know what? Well, that was that time. That was the time when Aaron wanted me to train Cordo. Maybe I would have changed that.
Maybe he would have like different practical jokes.
Maybe he would have fun in training because
maybe paint eyebrows on his.
Then he's living a miserable life, man. I don't know if that's the way he is, in you know, in his personal life.
He seems like that 24/7.
I don't know. I don't know him personally. You know, I've met him a couple of times, but
does he have a smile?
No, you're right. But he lives a miserable life. I don't know if he's got problems with his wife or friends or whatever, family problems. But I don't know. I don't think that's a healthy lifestyle. You gotta have fun. You gotta enjoy what you do. You gotta enjoy going to the gym. You gotta have fun. You gotta have friends around and joke around. And look, it's been nothing but positive in my team.
So your prediction, Margarito Cotto 2?
We do it again. We do the same thing again. You know, I know that you know, Margarito did it once. He could do it again. You know, they've both gone through some pretty tough fights against Pacquiao since. But Margarito's just stronger, bigger, physically stronger, and hungry to prove everybody wrong. So I think that makes a difference.
Before Brandon won his championship, a lot of people were doubting him. When he won it, they say he got lucky. Now they can't say either, because he was so convincing against a guy that only had 2 losses and he lost the champions. So what does that say about Brandon Rios, winning so convincingly?
You know what, to me, what I say about Brandon Rios is he's the best at lightweight. There's nobody out there that could even compete against him. And even at 40, when he moves up to 140, that's also gonna happen. Because we're, you know, with 2 fights, you know, from that happening. So it'll be, you know, he gets more experience. He gets his body, you know, we're gonna build his body into a junior welterweight, which will make a big difference. He's gonna be so strong for the junior welterweight. Awesome, but there is still there's always gonna be talk, you know, especially if when it comes to somebody training in my gym, there's always gonna be comments and talks about, oh, Antion was ranked number 12, or Antion wasn't even, you know, that
they didn't
good.
Say that before the fight.
That's gonna happen.
Antion just fought the fight of the century, the fight before that. They can't say that. Antion fought the fight of the century.
But people will say that.
A lot of people thought
even Brandon fought.
A lot of people thought that Antion really had a chance against Brandon.
Yeah.
Brandon just came in there and just took his heart, his soul, his mind. He just took it all.
Just the way it is, and that just the way we have to live. We have to live with this, you know, and it just makes us, me, my team, stronger. You know, hearing all that and reading all that just makes us stronger, and we laugh about those comments. We laugh about those people saying that we're still not ready, or that we still need this, we still need that. No, I think we're ready. Mikey's ready. Brandon's ready. Nonito is one of the best pound-for-pound fighters in the world right now.
Mikey's not going to get no fights, because Mikey's going to be hard for Mikey. Is anybody going to look? Anybody who looks at Mikey realize he's too strong, too, for that weight. Mikey looks sick, man.
It's going to cost Top Rank a lot of money to be able to get a champion to fight to fight Mikey.
Exactly.
But Top Rank is the best, and they got the money, so they better make it happen.
Hey, listen to the last comments and what they said about Mikey. This is a next superstar in boxing, period. This guy has what it takes. This guy's a complete package. Did you hear him talk? He sounded like a professor after he got to whooping ass. He sounded like a professor. He was talking so rapid.
Is this a guy in boxing?
¿Cómo te gusta el gimnasio de Robo?
Está muy lindo y muy agradecido por Roberto, que nos deja venir aquí a trabajar con Víctor y bueno, muy agradecido a él.
I'm very grateful, and you know, this is one of the best gyms out and stuff, you know, so you know, help each other out, man.
Everybody's telling me today that the gym is very quiet because Brandon Rios is not here. Do you notice that?
Dice que el gimnasio está muy tranquilo hoy por la razón que este bicho Brandon está aquí echando la pelota.
Bueno, pero nosotros acá cuando no está él se extraña hablando porque le da alegría el gimnasio aquí.
Yeah, absolutely, man. We definitely miss him, especially when he's not here. You know, we miss that whole vibe that he brings to the gym.
Did you see his fight?
¿Me has visto pelear de él?
Sí.
What did you think about the third round knockout?
¿Qué pasó de la pelea?
Y ya sabía que iba a pasar eso. Brandon es muy fuerte y había que aguantarlo. Y pasó lo que tenía que pasar.
Yeah, he said it was a great fight, and it happened what was supposed to happen in the fight. And, he knew that he was going to knock him out early.
So, there you have it, another episode of the Robert Garcia Reality Show. For ESPNReporting.com, Melly Stackback reporting.